Let's talk about it. Cowboys. Oh, God.
Yeah. You know, the NFC, people call it the NFC least. I have more respect for the division, so I don't call them that. I call them the NFC East.
It's the least.
As they are named, because it's always interesting, not just because of the Cowboys, because we never exactly know what we're going to get from the Giants, the Eagles, or the Washington football team, who still don't have a name yet, I guess, in a way. So, Cowboys, we know that they're 8-4. They fresh off of a victory over the Saints on Thursday night. We know that they're going to be there. We know about Dak, Zeke, Amari, CeeDee Lamb, Micah Parsons, Diggs. We know about all that. But what we can't quite figure out is the Washington football team and the Philadelphia Eagles. Washington is, as you just talked about, they're 6-6 now, 4 wins in a row post Chase Young injury. Like I was talking about, everybody elevates, cumulative effect. Right, and then you have the Eagles, who have won 3 of their last 4, 6-7. One of your, no, it wasn't one of your picks, but they beat the Jets yesterday.
I almost picked them. I should have picked them over the freaking Bengals.
Right. So with that, is it fair or unfair to say that Dallas is in trouble with the emergence of the football team and the Eagles?
I'm not going to say, well, actually, I'm going to say yes. I'll just go ahead and just put it out there. I think the Cowboys are only in trouble because their offense is looking pedestrian. It's not looking like it was. The defense has stepped up and is doing their job.
Yes.
I mean, Trayvon Diggs has 9 interceptions. Didn't we say that he was going to have double-digit interceptions this season? Yeah, he will. He's got, what, 5 weeks left?
5 games, yeah.
5 games left. He'll get probably a pick every game, it feels like.
I'll say 3 more.
I'll say 3 more.
Out of 12, yeah.
Yeah, because the record is what? Is it 12?
I think the record's like 14 or 15.
I'll look that up in a second. But I think
train lane.
Right. I think the Cowboys are going to have problems because they have Washington twice. By having Washington twice, there is a good chance that Washington could give them problems. And they got Philadelphia as well, who is showing as a power run offense. They're competitive. I mean, they may not have the best quarterback, and Jalen Hurts is still young, and you can tell the rookie mistakes. Gardner Minshew walked in there and got them a W.
He always does this.
He does. Minshew mania, baby. That stash did it. You see him and his dad embrace each other?
No.
That was beautiful. I got to show you. I'll send you the video. It was awesome. They were hyped, and eventually Minshew started crying because he was so hyped with his dad and everything because his dad tries to make every single game. But, I think that the Cowboys, if they can't get their offense going, they may have problems with Washington and Philadelphia. What you think?
I think so. I think that, you know, the Philadelphia Eagles, they're like this cornered psychotic animal. And you don't know if they're going to bite.
What?
You don't know if they're going to bite off their own leg or bite off your leg. They're that crazy. You don't know what to expect.
So they're the assistant coach's monkey in Texas, right? With the Longhorns?
Let's not talk about that. but you never know what you're going to get from this team. So, I mean, there are games where, like, their 3 wins out of the last 4, they were all blowouts. They dominated those teams. And then Jalen Hurts just, you know, crapped the bed against the New York Giants. Should have won that game. Had a chance to win that game despite his interceptions. So you don't know. When they go up against Dallas, and this is somewhat of a rivalry, I guess Dallas really has a rivalry with every team in this division, you don't know what you're going to get, especially in Philadelphia. Same with the Washington football team. They're not like a cornered psychotic animal. They're very much in the mold of Ron Rivera. They really don't beat themselves. They fight you tooth and nail to the end, but they do have talent. I think they have more talent than the Eagles do, especially on offense. And like you said, Taylor Heineke is just pure will. I mean, obviously, we know that he's more of a backup, more of a really good backup than a good starter, but he just finds a way to will his team. A 17-15 victory, that means somebody on that team with 17 willed them to a victory, and that's typically Taylor Heineke. So, again, they have some things clicking. You do have a good receiver in Terry McLaurin. Your running game is back. Somehow this defense has found a way to play better without Chase Young. I think that they've given up, I want to say, 19 or less in each game in this 4-game win streak, something like that.
Yep. So, they held Tampa Bay to 19. That was when Chase Young tore his ACL.
And that was kind of the beginning of, you know, of their emergence. So I think that Dallas really needs to, even more so than they normally do, take both of these teams serious. I wouldn't be surprised if they split with both teams. If you're Dallas and you can go 3-1 between your 4 games with each of these 2 teams, that's a major victory. That's a major victory because, in a way, in order for Dallas to do that, and Dallas going into the playoffs, you're going to want to have that edge. You're going to want to have been through the type of battles that these teams are going to take you through. Because if you think you're going to come up in the playoffs against a team like the Cardinals, the Packers, or the Bucks, you can't be finesse Dallas. You have to be Dallas with some dog in them, and going up against Washington and Philly will give you that.
Exactly, and they're going to beat you up because they're traveling to Washington and New York in back-to-back games, and then Washington comes to the house. Mm-hmm. the Cardinals come to the house to start next year, and then they travel to Philly to end the season. So Dallas, you got to find a way to win the division. I mean, you need to go 5-0. If you go 5-0, that's the number one seed, and that helps even more, gives you that week off, which might not be a good thing for Dallas. It seems like when they have weeks off, they don't do very well. But you've got to be able to pull this out, because if you don't, what's going to happen? You're going to fail.
It'd be same old, same old.
Same old, same old.